Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Yuvi, and if you're just joining us for the first time, I want to say welcome to Yuvi's vlog. And to all my subscribers, I want to say a big thank you. You guys mean a lot to me. Like, thank you so much for sticking with me up until now. In my previous video on how I moved to Cape Verde, I made mention that I had been getting a ton of questions from a lot of people asking me things like, where is Cape Verde? What continent is it in? What's the climate like? What do the people look like? I also mentioned in that same video that I will be making another video talking entirely about Cape Verde. So this is that video. In this video, I'll be sharing with you 10 facts you probably didn't know about Cape Verde. So if this is the kind of thing that interests you, you definitely should watch this. Make sure to watch this video till the end because I'll be sharing with you some extra fun facts that will definitely blow your mind, that will definitely shock you about Cape Verde. So keep watching. Cape Verde, which is officially known as the Republic of Cabo Verde, is an archipelago of 10 islands on the central Atlantic Ocean off the coast of Northwest Africa. These 10 islands are Sal, Boa Vista, San Vicente, Santantão, Fogo, Santiago, São Nicolau, Maio, Brava, and Santa Luzia. The first Cape Verdean island appeared about 15 million years ago after a volcanic eruption in the ocean caused molten magma to solidify, thereby creating the first island we know today as Sal. While the youngest island is the island of Fogo, which is estimated to be about 100,000 years old and has an active volcano till date. After this archipelago was discovered in the 15th century by some Portuguese explorers, it became a major location for Atlantic slave trade, with slaves brought in from all parts of Africa. So it is highly possible that Cape Verdeans, who probably be watching this video, are Igbos, Yorubas, or Hausas. The official language in Cape Verde is Portuguese, while the indigenous or the native language is Creole. And apparently, Creole is just an adapted version of Portuguese. Also, the currency used here in Cape Verde is the Cape Verdean escudo, which has a symbol that kind of resembles the dollar sign, but just has two zeros placed after it. Cape Verde is neighbors with the Western Sahara to the northeast, Mauritania, Senegal, and Gambia to the east, and Guinea-Bissau to the southeast. The largest of the islands is Santiago, and it is also the most populated, with about 27,947 inhabitants. I think it's actually the most populated because it actually holds the capital city of Praia. Yeah, Praia is the capital of Cape Verde. While the smallest island with a population of about 6,043 people is Brava. The highest peak in Cape Verde, with a height of about 9,281 feet above sea level, is the Pico do Fogo, which is apparently the peak of the volcanic mountain on Fogo Island. While the lowest point, with a radius of about 900 meters, is the Pedra de Lumi crater, also known as Salt Lakes. Even though Cape Verde is just an upcoming country, it is considered by some as the Europe of Africa. And this is not just because of its cooler climate being an island and all, but also because it is one of the most developed and democratic countries in Western Africa. And this is probably why it attracts a lot of European foreigners from countries like France, the US, the UK, Portugal, Brazil, Germany, Luxembourg, and many others. As of this year, the total Cape Verdean population is estimated to be around 548,800 people, with even more Cape Verdeans living abroad than in their own country. Is that not shocking? And lastly, Cape Verdeans enjoy a subtropical climate with high winds and little or no rainfall between the months of August and September. The most popular Cape Verdean dish that everyone knows around the world is cachupa. Cachupa, it's a combination of beans, corn, sausages, a lot of things. Like, they just combine everything together. But apparently, it's not the most served dish here in Cape Verde. The most served dish is white rice with French fries and grilled chicken with mayonnaise and ketchup and veggies. That's actually the most served dish here. I have to say this, like, Cape Verdeans are such caring and nice people that they always like to share their meals with people, even strangers, you know? I remember I was at the salon making this hair, and this hairdresser kept offering me things. She offered me pizza, she offered me Coke, she offered me biscuits, she offered me a lot of things, and I kept saying no, 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 because I'm not used to accepting things from people I don't know or complete strangers, right? But yeah, when she offered me the biscuit after I had turned down everything, I had to take it and put it in my bag because I didn't want to seem rude. Like, I kept saying no, 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 thank you, I don't want, thank you. But yeah, like, don't be surprised if you get here and you see a complete stranger maybe just eating beside you and he's like, oh, do you want some? Like, it's a normal thing here. So you know the way a lot of Nigerians have family members living in Italy. That's the same way Cape Verdeans have a lot of family members living in the US. I've met some Cape Verdeans who have been in the US for like 10 years, 20 something years, 30 years. Like, yeah, this one really shocked me. Here in Cape Verde, apparently, wildlife is non-existent. I mean, a lot of Cape Verdeans, I mean, majority of Cape Verdeans have never seen a snake before in their life. In Nigeria, anywhere you go, even in my house, we've seen snakes before. In school, we used to see snakes at the border. You know, we see snakes everywhere. It's like normal, normal. You see snakes, just ask a snake. Oh. But most Cape Verdeans have never seen a snake. Only on TV that they've seen snakes. They're like, dude, I don't know what a snake looks like physically. I only see it on TV. I'm like, wow. The only wildlife you see are dogs. I mean, stray dogs. And stray cats and stray cows. They have a lot of strays. I don't just know. I mean, like, dude, so many strays everywhere. Stray dogs, stray cats, stray cows. Then you see some chicken in some places. You see ducks as well. You see donkeys. They don't really have much. That's basically the totality of what they have. And maybe a few other animals that I'm yet to see, right? But these are the only ones I have seen. Now, in Cape Verde, if a guy harasses a lady, maybe in the course of an argument, and he loses his temper and he slaps her or he hits her in any way, and she lets the police know, she reports to the police, he's entitled or he will be forced to pay her a fine of 5,000 escudo. Like, he must pay to her. I was shocked. And when my sister heard this, she was like asking the guy who told us, please, can you just slap me now so I just report and so you can give me 5,000 escudo. In Cape Verde, wearing of rings on the wedding finger is actually something that's very common. Not just amongst those who are married, which is normal everywhere in the world, but amongst those who are in serious relationships. And the only way to differentiate between the two is that those who are married, they wear gold bands, that's gold rings. While those who are not married or who are just in serious relationships, they wear silver rings. And they say they wear it like that so they could ward off people who want to disturb them. So they're like, oh yeah, I'm in a serious relationship. For this one, I am not really sure about it because I don't have any proof, but I'm just gonna say it because we were told when we got here that if a girl should stay with her boyfriend for more than 6 months, like they live together for over 6 months, that she's entitled to half of his property. Like, okay, that means if I date some Cape Verdean guy now like this and I live with him for 6 months, that means I'm as good as being his wife because I'm entitled to half of his property. That is insane, right? This is the end of the 10 facts you probably didn't know about Cape Verde. With all these facts I have shared with you today, do you think Cape Verde is the kind of country you would like to live in or not? Let me know in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please don't forget to give it a thumbs up, drop your comments, and subscribe to my channel so you get notified when I make new posts. Feel free to share this video with your friends and loved ones you feel might be interested in learning about Cape Verde. Thank you so much. Ciao.